Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today I'm going to take a look at my Black & Decker hedge clipper. This thing here. Show you what's wrong with it. If you look right in there, it's missing one of the plug ends. And I'm going to take it apart and we're going to see what's going on with it inside there and how I can repair it. And if I can repair it. I'm sure I'll figure something out. But it has to be kind of sturdy because you're going to be, you know, I'll be sticking the extension cord in there, plugging it in, pulling it out. So I don't want it to, like, just break off. It can't be just a quick temporary fix. So whatever I do, it has to be fairly sturdy. All right, from what I could see, I'm going to need a Phillips head to remove these screws and a flat head to remove the one screw here that holds the handle on. All right. I think I'm going to start by removing the handle. Okay, that's fully loosened. Remove the nut. And now just pop the long screw out. That off. Put this back together so I don't lose the nut. Okay, and now on this side we got 1, 2, and I'm sure there's one in there. Let me see. Yeah, something's in there deep. Let's get a closer look. No. Looks like there was a screw up there, but it's been removed. So we don't have to remove that one. It either fell out or it was removed previously. Now I'm going to be a little careful here when I split this apart. Make sure stuff doesn't go flying anywhere. I might have to remove this top cap too. That might be keeping the two halves together. So let me just take a look here. Nope. Okay, so I'm going to leave it laying down like that and pull this half apart. Okay, so this is what we got going on in there. Got the one plug here and the other blade was right there, but from the way it looks, it had like a little angle on it that kept it in its place, but then the other half of the plug end there went through and that's where the wires were connected. Alright, let's try to pull this one out and just see how it goes in there. Alright, so that's the neutral, and you can kind of see there it's cracked. So if that little end cracked, that blade would have fell off too. And then take this one out of there. Interesting. I thought this was a little like a piece of cardboard in there that maybe the manufacturer put in there to keep the plug prongs in place, but the truth is that's a little piece of wood that I'm sure my dad had messed with this and got it working again, so he knew there was an issue with it, but the plugs were probably pushing in as he was trying to plug the extension cord in, and he probably put that block of wood in there to keep them from backing out, but I'll have to figure something out there as well, but we got to get this plug out of there. It kind of was shorting and stuff, so it looks like it melted the plastic a little bit. Hope I can get this out. All go. So obviously this thing is trashed and worthless. But yeah, it's a little melted here because it must have been shorting out. It was making a little bit of contact with the prong that was still in the extension cord, and then momentarily making contact with this, and it was shortening and melted out the plastic. So I'm going to have to completely remove that and then figure out where to get one of those. All right. So I'm going to find something that has a prong similar to that inside it. Found this thing in the toolbox. I'm going to take it apart and see if maybe one of these will work. All right, I got the this little plug thing off, and this is what it looks like on the inside. And I think I could find a way to make this work. So let's take a look. The funny thing is, sometimes I still think like I'm 10 or 12 or 13 years old and don't have a job or money, because I consistently try to improvise and use stuff that I already have laying around to repair things. I know I should be smarter than that. I just look it up. I could probably find this, you know, part online at, you know, Black & Decker or whatever, order two new prongs, solder them in, be done with it. Or, like a lot of people do, throw this piece of crap in the garbage and buy a new one. But I just find, like, I get more satisfaction out of repairing something as long as it's going to last. I'm not trying to rig it where it's unsafe or not going to work for very long. You know, I think if you look at this, I just bent that up and it's pretty much going to fit in that slot now. I may have to squish that a little bit more, but what I'm trying to do here is I'm going to put my little needle nose in there like that, and then if I grab my other needle nose and squeeze it here, it will retain that little opening in there, which will sort of act like that little bracket does on this side. It'll still have some stuff. Plus, it's kind of melted, so I think I can make it work. Even if I have to snip the end of this one that's wrapping around, making it around this side here. If I just cut that end off, it'll make it a little bit thinner, might, and it won't be, there won't be as much pressure here, too. So I'm going to dry fit it here. Let's see how that little tight. The plastic here is, when it melted, it kind of, you know, made the gap a little tighter. So I might have to either snip or file that down. I'm going to squeeze this a little tighter. See, it is a little long, so I think I'm going to snip this end off. You know what, though? That was kind of holding it together, but oh well. Got that. Looks like that now. So even though that's long, it sort of looks more like this one did here. So I'll have to trim that. The plastic here has kind of fused a little bit. And it's making it difficult to get in there. So I'm going to see what I could get in there to clean that up. A hacksaw blade would work perfect. I just don't know if I have enough clearance to slide it back and forth. But I'm going to give it a shot. Alright, so I removed the blade. Let's see if I could even get in there. Maybe if I go at an angle like this, maybe. Gotta make sure I don't cut this blade, this wire. So now let's see if it fits. All right. So it's kind of in there. There we go. Now let's see if it's the same length out as this one. Yeah, close enough. So now all I have to do is solder those wires onto that prong and we should be okay. Now this one here, you know, might have to reinforce it, and this one here maybe I can bend it so that it touches this post and we'll keep it from backing off. We're backing in. So I'm going to try bending that real quick. Alright, I've made a little bend in it. Let's see if that helps. Yeah, that'll help. And the only thing is when you're pulling the plug out, it feels pretty good in there. So, might be alright. So now I just have to loosen the solder on here and hook it up to there. Alright, from the way it looked, that other plug prong was just crimped on to the wire, so I'm not going to bother with solder or anything. I'm just going to take this out and squeeze it in there. Bend that wire over a little bit here. Alright, so that's in there. No soldering. Twist that a little bit. Alright, well, I actually think that might just work. And this one, you know, it's on its way out, honestly, but I'm gonna let it fly for now. As seldom as I use this thing, I think it'll hold up for a couple years, just like that. Worst case scenario, I use the other one of these. Alright, let's put the cover back on, test it out. Alright, let's get this cover back on. Alright, fully reassembled. Let's go out and plug it in. Alright, I've got a plug in the wall there, or an extension cord, I should say. And here's the other end of it. Here's the repaired plug prong. I'm going to plug it in and see if it works. So there, we're in. I'm gonna try not to cut the cord here. No problem. Let's unplug it and see. Pulls out perfectly. It's in there nice and tight. I think that's gonna last a while, just like that. So there we are, repaired 16 inch cut. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, 16 inch cut Black and Decker hedge trimmer. No parts that I had to buy. Thanks for watching, guys, and take care.